स्टैंडर्ड 7th सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस, चैप्टर नंबर 6, एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव सिस्टम एंड आर्किटेक्चर ड्यूरिंग द मेडिवियल एज। इन पार्ट 1 वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव सिस्टम एंड द लिटरेचर ऑफ राजपूत रूलर्स, हाउ दे रन देयर किंगडम, हाउ दे कलेक्ट द टेक्स्ट फ्रॉम देयर सिटीजन्स एंड वॉट आर देयर लिटरेरी works done at the time of Rajput rulers, which books were written, which are the contents of this book. We have learned about that in our part 1. But in today, part 2, we are going to learn about the architecture, means the buildings constructed by the Rajput kings. Among the various constructions during the Rajput age, temples were very noteworthy. The Rajput kings were fond of constructing grand and artistic buildings. The architecture and sculpture of that time is evident from temple, fort, palaces, lakes, etc. As we all know that Rajput rulers were fond of great buildings. We can see in their forts, palaces of Rajasthan, Gujarat, grand temples in Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Rajasthan, and in many more states of India. Among these temples, Khajuraho in Madhya Pradesh, remember this, Khajuraho temple in Madhya Pradesh. Second is Puri temple of Lord Jagannath are famous for their architecture in sculpture. Puri temple, this temple is of Lord Jagannath. Third is Sun Temple of Konark was also beautiful during that time. These all are the grand temple built at the time of Rajput rulers, made of rocks. The Konark Temple was constructed with great fineness and was shaped like a chariot driven by 7 horses. You can see in the right side of this temple, chariots means rath. You can see the wheels on the right side and left side of the temple. It means there is a rath and the rath is carrying a temple. This chariot is driven by 7 horses. Among the other sun temples of India, the Marthan temple of Kashmir and the Modhera sun temple of Gujarat are famous. This is the Modhera sun temple of Gujarat. The Modhera Sun Temple of Gujarat is made in the way that the first ray of sun fall directly on the idol of this temple. After this architecture of temple, let's move towards the Ellora Caves of the Deccan, Ajanta Ellora Caves. This represents 3 religion: Hinduism, Buddhism, and Jainism. Ellora Caves represents 3 religion: Hinduism, Buddhism, and Jainism. One among these is the Grand Kailas Temple. The Elephanta Caves near Mumbai have 3 faced sculpture of Lord Shiv. The Meenakshi Temple at Madurai is also famous all over India. The temple of South India are specially well known for imposing gateways called Gopuram. These types of gateways we can see in all the South Indian temples. And these gateways are known as Gopurams. It is made up of many floors. After hearing about the fame of such grand temples, many foreign inventors came to loot them. Inventors means the people who forcefully entered the other regions to capture them. They are known as invaders. The magnificent Somnath Temple of Gujarat was attacked many times. We have learned about this and we are going to learn about this in future, that Somnath Temple was attacked by many foreign rulers for its wealth. Till then, the Rajput rulers were ruling all over the India. After invaders came or arrived in India. There were many other religions came into existence in India and they started ruling over India. In the next part of our chapter, we are going to learn about how the foreign invaders entered in India and how they started ruling over the India. Thank you.